Great, welcome. We will start with lecture number 2 of the mechanism. In the previous lecture, we discussed about one of the quick return motion mechanism, the drag link mechanism. So today we will discuss about the another quick return motion mechanism that is called as a Whitworth quick return motion mechanism. So in the previous we have discussed this. So today we will discuss about the Whitworth quick return motion mechanism. So similarly, in the next lecture we will discuss about the crank and slotted lever quick return motion mechanism, right? So this is the person, Whitworth, who invented the quick return motion mechanism, right? So this is the animation that you can see. So compared to the drag link mechanism, which was an extension of the four bar mechanism, you find that this is one of the inversions of a slider crank mechanism. You can observe that there is a slider here attached to the red link. So in a simple way, you can observe here, this is point is called as S, this point is called as Q, right? So when the tool moves from S to Q, that is the cutting stroke, and you can observe quickly Q to S, right? It returns back quickly. So we will go into the construction and working principle of a Whitworth quick return motion mechanism, right? Now this is the construction. What are the things that you can see here? We have link number 2. This is the second inversion of a slider crank mechanism, and I assume that link number 2 is the fixed link, right? There is a link 3 to which link number 4, that is the slider, is attached, and the slider can move back and forth through link 1, and the slider can complete 360 degree rotation, right? So complete 4 can complete 360 degree rotation, right? The slider can go around completely. It rotates by sliding through link number 1. And this single slider crank mechanism, right, is extended. So there is a point A, point B, and point C, right? At point C, slider is attached, which can reciprocate along link number 1. Now this is where the mechanism end, right? So now from point A, I am going to extend the link 1 till point D. So this is nothing but simply extension of link number 1. So here I can find that again this point D is capable of making complete 360 degree rotation. Both one end of the link 1, that is 4, or the slider, and another end of the link 1, that is point D, both complete 360 degree rotation. That is what we have to remember. Now point D is connected to the tool through link number 5. It is nothing but a connector link. This is just a connecting, something like a connecting rod or a coupler. It connects point D to the tool. I have connected point D to the tool via link number 5. Currently the tool is at position E, right? So the tool, the link number for the tool is shown as 6. Now we will quickly go in to see how exactly this particular configuration generates a quick return motion, right? So now what I am going to do, so this is the mechanism that is given to me. Now you can appreciate that both point D as well as the slider, that is point C, both can complete 360 degree rotation. The path traced by point C is shown as a circle, as well as the path traced by point D is also shown as a circle for your convenience, right? Now to make the things simple, right, now currently it is at point E, but I want it to come to one of the extreme ends. So this I am going to consider it as the start position. So this I am going to consider it as the end position. So let me bring the E to E1, which is nothing but the start. So let me call this as the start point, and let me call this as the end point, and this becomes the stroke, right? So when it moves from left to right, it becomes the cutting stroke. Right to left, it becomes the return stroke, that we already know. So what I do is, so now I bring C to C1. Let me assume that I am going to bring it manually. C moves to C1, and correspondingly D moves to D1, right? So now the current position is C1, D1, and E1. Currently I am in E1. My next task is to move from E1 to E2, that is left to right, by making a cutting stroke. This is what my next motion is. I want to do a cutting stroke, right? So for that I need to move from C1 to C2 and D1 to D2. We will explore that in the next slide here. So there was a C. From C I came to point C1. From D I came to point D1. So similarly E came to E1. Right now I am in E1, and my objective is to move from E1 to E2 to produce the cutting stroke. Now I know that the mechanism rotates in a counterclockwise direction. So now C1, right, along this path moves to C2. Observe carefully. So C1 has moved to C2 in the counterclockwise direction. When C1 moves to C2 in the counterclockwise direction, so this is the line for C1. So this is the line for C2. It travels through an angle alpha. So angle alpha indicates the cutting stroke angle, right? So similarly, when C1 moves to C2, correspondingly D1 moves to D2, right? So the mechanism is generating, is moving like this, right? So opposite to the movement of C, so we observe the movement of D, right? So when the mechanism rotates in the counterclockwise direction, so D1 moves to D2 in this direction. So now I am currently at C2, this is my current position, D2, right? And E1 to E2. So I have already come to E2 by traveling through an angle alpha, and currently I am residing at E2, and one forward stroke has been completed by traveling through angle alpha. My next objective is to move from again E2 back to E1, and I am going to call that as the return stroke, right? So this movement back from E2 to E1 is called as the return stroke. To what to do for that? I am already in C2. Right now I should move back to C1. So C2 to C1. When I move back from C2 to C1, you can observe here, this is the line for C2, this is the line for C1. I am going to travel through an angle beta, right? And the return stroke angle correspondingly will be called as angle beta. Now if we appreciate this angle, so this angle is called as alpha and this angle is called as beta. So I can appreciate that alpha is greater than beta. And this is the property which occurs because of the construction of the mechanism or geometry of the mechanism, and not by any other reasons, right? So when I move from C2 to C1 and again D2 to D1 in this path, right, and similarly E2 comes back to E1, right? So that is called as a return stroke. Forward stroke, it travels through an angle alpha. Return stroke, it travels through an angle beta. And we find that through this geometry or through the diagram, we find that alpha is greater than beta, thus generating a quick return mechanism, right? So the same thing you can observe here. S to Q is the forward stroke, Q to S is the return stroke. So the highlighted thing is shown as the input one. The red color is shown as the input. You can see that the slider reciprocates along the link one, right? The same thing you can observe here in this video demonstration, right? So there is a small video demonstration where we can observe the forward stroke as well as the return stroke. The one thing, the one that you find in the green color, so you can observe the direction here. The one that you find in the green color is the forward stroke, and one that you find in the red color will be the return stroke, right? So green color consumes more angle, and the green color produces more angle, thus consuming more time. Red color produces less angle, thus consuming less time. Therefore, return stroke will be quicker when compared to the forward stroke. So that is the basic property of a Whitworth quick return mechanism. So again, this is a small project demo done by few students. So you can just appreciate how exactly a Whitworth quick return motion mechanism work, right? So left to right is the cutting stroke, right to left is the return stroke. Return should occur as quickly as possible. Slider should reciprocate along link one, right? Both slider as well as the extended point of link one should complete 360 degrees rotation, right? This is the Whitworth quick return motion mechanism. So this ends lecture number 2. In the lecture number 3, we will see how exactly the crank and slotted lever quick return mechanism is going to work. Thank you.